Assalamu alaikum students, how is your? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D22 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to mathematics O-level past papers. It's May 2019. I'm going to explain you question number 7 of paper 2. Students, I have uploaded the videos for the previous questions, so you can watch those videos for the rest of the questions. So here you can see that the two functions are given to you. F of x, which is 5x minus 7. And g of x, which is equal to x plus 4 over 3. And part A is find f of 6. So f of 6 means that this is the f of function. Now, so first write down this function. So f of 6 means that in place of x, you will put 6. Okay. So here I'm going to find out f of 6. So now you will substitute the value of x, which is 6. Okay. So 5x minus 7. So you write down 5. Now, in place of x, you will put its value. You will substitute its value, which is 6 minus 7. So, f of 6 will be equal to 5, 6 are 30. 30 minus 7. So, f of 6 will be equal to, when you will subtract 7 from 30, you will get 23. So, this is your answer. So, you write down f of 6 is equal to 23. All right, let's come to part B. Part B is find g of x. So g of x, the function of g of x is gx is x plus 4 over 3. Suppose this is equal to y, take it equal to y. So you write down y is equal to, now what you need to do is whenever you have to find out g of x, what you need to do is you have to write down, okay, you have to suppose that the g of x is equal to g inverse x is equal to y. So if you, now you have supposed that g inverse x is equal to y, so in place of g of x is equal to y, so in place of g of x you will put y, and I'll write down its function, which is x plus 4 over 3. Students, in the question we have to find out g inverse x. So it means that you have to make x as subject. So this 3 is dividing over here. If we come to this side, we multiply with y, and you will get 3y is equal to x plus 4. Now we have to make x as subject. So this 4, when it will come to this side, will be subtracted from 3y. So x would be equal to 3y minus 4. Alright. So now what we need to do is, so thus x is equal to g of inverse x is equal to, now in place of y you will put x, so 3x minus 4. So your answer is g of inverse x is equal to 3x minus 4. Alright, I hope that it's clear to you. So, in this question you just need to remember that first you have to assume that, suppose that the g of x is equal to y, and you have to make it equal to y, then you have to make x as subject, and you know that x is equal to g of inverse x, and then place of y you will put x. Okay, that would be your answer. Now let's come to part C. Part C is, given that f of p is equal to g of p minus 2 is find p. So first we have to find out f of p and g of p. Okay, we can write down the values. Okay, so f of p, the f function is given to you, which is fx minus 7. So f of x is equal to 5x minus 7 is equal to, and g of x is equal to 4 over 3. So what we will do is, for f of p in this function, in place of this x, I will put its value, I will substitute the value p, because we have to find out f of p. So in place of x, I'll put p, and in this function for g of x, which is equal to x plus 4 over 3, in place of x, I will substitute its value, which is p, because we have to find out g of p. And then I'll write down this equation. F of p mean that in this f function, you will put p in place of x. So 5x is equal to 5x minus 7. So you write down 5p minus 7, and it is equal to, now this is g of p, so in g function, which is x plus 4 over 3, in place of x you will put its value, which is p. पी. सो यू राइट डाउन पी प्लस 4/3 एंड देन दिस इज माइनस 2. यू राइट पुट यू विल सब्ट्रैक्ट माइनस लाइक दिस माइनस 2. All right, now this, when you multiply f 5 with p, you will get 5p minus 7. And here on this side, you can take the LCM. Here it will come 1. So 3 would be the LCM. And 3 1s are 3 and 1 3s are 3. So now, multiply p plus 4 with 1, you will get p plus 4. And now minus 2 3s are 6. I have taken the LCM over here. Okay, all right. Okay, now I can, what I will get when I will plus 4 and minus 6. Write down 5p minus 7 as it is. Now p plus 4 minus 6. Plus minus is minus. So you have to subtract 4 from 6. So you will get 2. And you have to write down the sign of the bigger number, which is minus. You write down p minus 2/3. Now you can put 1 over here and you can cross multiply. Alright. Now, when I multiply 3 with 5p 7, I will write down 3, 5p. Minus 7, I have done the cross multiplication over here. So I'm going to multiply 3 with this and 1 with p minus 2. And 1 is equal to multiply by p minus 2. So you will get 5 3s are 15p. Minus 3 7s are 21 is equal to p minus 2. And you will multiply this with 1, we will get p minus 2. Now we have to make, because we have to find out the value of p, so we'll make p as subject. So move this p to this side and move this 21 to that side. This p is adding over here. When it will come to this side, it will be subtracted from 15p. So you will get 15p minus p. I have moved this p to this side. Now is equal to, what's the constant over here? It's minus 2. Now I have moved, I will move this 21 to this side, to the right hand side. It's subtracting over here. It will come to this side. It will add in minus 2. Alright, so 15p minus p will be equal to 14p. Plus minus is minus. You will subtract 1 from 15, you will get 14p. And when you will subtract 2 from 21, plus minus is minus, it means that you have to subtract 2 from 21. So what you will get? 19. So now we have to find out the value of p. So this 14 is multiplying with p, that will come to this side, it will be divided with 19. So p will be equal to 19/14. So p will be equal to 19/14. All right. I hope that it's clear to you. Part C is clear to you. Now let's move forward to part D. All right. So part D is g of f(5x) minus 7 is equal to ax plus b. Now see the g function is given to you. Here the g function is gx is equal to x plus 4/3. So here we have to find out g of 5x minus 7. So g of, first write down the function of g, which is g of x is equal to x plus 4/3. So we have to find out g of 5x minus 7. So what I will do is, in place of x, I will substitute its value, which is 5x minus 7. Okay? So you write down, in place of x, you write down this value, which is 5x minus 7. We have to find out the value of a and b in this part. Is equal to, in place of x, I write down its value, which is 5x minus 7. So in place of this x. So I will write down 5x minus 7 plus 4/3. Okay, now I will solve this side. Alright, now write in 5x as it is. Now these two are the like terms, these two both are the constants, so I'll solve them together. Alright, so minus plus is minus, so it means that you will subtract 4 from 7. When you will subtract 4 from 7, what you will get? 3. So students, you have to write down the sign of the bigger number. So the bigger number is 7, with 7 is minus 7. So you write down minus 3. /3. All right. So now you will divide this 3 with these both numbers separately like this. 5/3x minus 3/3. All right. When I will solve it, so what I will get? I will get 5/3x minus, when you will cut this 3 with this 3, you will get 1, minus 1. Now this is ax plus b. This is equal to ax plus b. So 5 over 3x minus 1 is equal to ax plus b. We have found this value, na? We have found this value, which is 5 over 3x minus 1. Now is which is equal to ax plus b. Now do the comparison. Compare values. Now compare values. 5 over 3x is ax. So it means that a is equal to 5 over 3. Ax plus b. So it means that b is equal to minus 1. Okay, so a is equal to 5 over 3 and b is equal to minus 1. Okay, students, I hope that today's lecture is clear to you. Here you can see, have a look on the whole sum. This question number 7. See the part A, B, C, and then D. I hope that today's lecture is clear to you. Do the practice of this sum, because when you'll do the practice in this concept, it will be more clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.